Hi, I'm Hari Subhash with Kinetica. As mentioned in previous videos, Kinetica's Graph API has four components: nodes, edges, weights, and restrictions. In this video, we will create a graph in Kinetica using two out of the four components, edges and weights. The graph we will create is special because one of the edges is repeated three times with different weights. This can represent scenarios like, say, a multi-lane highway where the same road segment is split into multiple lanes, each with its own specific characteristics, like, say, occupancy levels, the quality of the road, speed limits, etc. While we'll be using a really small sample table for this demo, mainly to illustrate the steps themselves can be applied to really large data sets with millions of rows of data. Let's start by taking a closer look at the data we'll be using for this exercise. This is the table we'll be loading into Kinetica later in this video. The column headers are a unique format that Kinetica uses for CSV files to automatically recognize information about each field. It uses a pipe operator to differentiate the different types of information. The first field indicates the name of the column, while the subsequent fields indicate the data types. Let's look at the second column first. It contains the WKT representation of a geospatial line. WKT, or well-known text, is a commonly used markup format used to represent geospatial objects. A line is represented using the longitude and latitude of its starting and ending points. Longitude and latitude are analogous to the X and Y axes in the Cartesian coordinate system. So for our data, the first edge starts from point 0,0 and ends at 10,10. The second one starts at 10,10 and ends at a longitude of 20 and a latitude of 0. Next, we have the three edges that go from 0,0 to 20,0, representing the different lanes of travel. And finally, we have the edge that goes from 20,0 to 30,10. Now let's add the directions. Directions are represented using an integer column that can take the value 0, 1, or 2. 0 indicates an edge that can be traversed from the starting node to the ending node. 1 indicates an edge that can be traversed both ways. And 2, an edge that can be traversed from the ending node to the starting node. In our case, all the edges except the one with ID 2 are marked 0, which indicates a direction of traversal from the starting node to the ending node, while the edge with ID 2 is marked 1, which indicates a bidirectional edge that can be traversed both ways. Finally, let's also indicate the weights as numbers on top of the edges. The important thing to remember when creating graphs in Kinetica is that we are trying to uniquely identify each of the components using the data that we have. In our case, this is slightly complicated by the fact that three of the edges share the same WKT line. So if we were to use the WKT line to identify each of these edges, we would not be able to do so. We solved this problem by adding an edge ID to our specification. Each ID is mapped to a unique edge. Using this specification, Kinetica can now identify each of the edges and create this graph. So in general, it is a good idea to always include edge IDs when possible. Now that we understand the data, let's go to Kinetica to create this graph. Right now, I'm in gadmin, which is the interface for performing various database tasks in Kinetica. Our first task is to load the CSV file into Kinetica. We can use the data importer tool in gadmin to load data for the graph table that is stored as a CSV on my local machine. Notice that the option for using the CSV schema format is selected. That looks good. Let's check the table to make sure it was imported correctly. So here we see the same table as earlier, with an edge ID, WKT line, direction, and weights. Now that we have this table imported correctly and in the format that we need, let's use it to create our graph. We will be using the graph interface on gadmin. The graph interface provides us a way to specify the different parameters for the graph. In our case, we are creating a directed graph with weights. Let's start by giving it a name. Next, let's specify the direction. The next set of inputs are used to specify the combinations that can be used to identify the different components of the graph. Let's start by taking a closer look at those for an edge. The list here is from the Kinetica documentation website. It provides a list of combinations that can be used to identify edges with optional specifications for direction as well. In our case, our table has an edge ID, an edge WKT line, and a direction. This maps to this combination here. The different identify combinations provided by Kinetica are meant to provide the user enough flexibility in terms of the different types of table schemas that can be used to create graphs in Kinetica. Now let's go back to GAdmin to finish creating this graph. First, let's pick the identify combo that we saw just now. Next, we map the different columns in the data to the specific identifier fields. In our case, it is the edge ID, WKT line, and the direction columns. We can repeat the same process for weights by using the edge IDs to identify the edges and then apply weights using the weights column in the table. This combo works because each edge ID uniquely identifies an edge. The right panel of this interface provides a set of options that we can use while creating graphs. Let's select the option to draw the graph so that we can see it rendered on a map once it is created. Let's also create an output table. While Kinetica uses an internal representation for graphs that is optimized for performance, the output table option provides a tabular representation of the same graph that is handy when we need to troubleshoot. Okay, now we are ready, so let's click on the Create Graph button. That looks good. As you can see, we have all the edges. One thing to note here is that since the edges 3, 4, and 5 share the same WKT line, they are depicted using a single line on this map. But we can look at the tabular representation of the graph that we specified just now to confirm that the graph was indeed created with all the different edges. As we can see, all the edge IDs are listed here, including those with the same WKT lines. Also note how Kinetica automatically generated the nodes that correspond to each edge of the graph. It did this internally using the intersection of the edges. This graph is now ready to be used in solvers to answer questions such as the shortest path between two points. So in this video, we created a directed graph in Kinetica using two out of the four components in Kinetica's graph API, edges and weights. The demo data, while small, did introduce a complex scenario where there were multiple edges between the same two nodes. The main point to remember is that when creating graphs in Kinetica, our key purpose is to uniquely specify each of the components of Kinetica's graph API by mapping our data to the different identify combinations provided by Kinetica. You can see a full list of all the identify combinations on Kinetica's documentation website. Thanks for watching.